Hey guys, David here at the Crystal Light Company. It's a rainy Saturday afternoon here in the mountains of Tennessee, and we've got the remnants of the hurricanes that just came through Texas, coming through our mountains now. Nothing really serious, just a little wind and some rain. But anyway, we're at home today, Dorinda and I, and through the home remodel, my garage, my man cave, has gotten in and quite a mess. And so I'm going to be working in the shop today, getting things cleaned up and organized. But I wanted to take the opportunity real quick while I was out here to talk to you about a change going on at the Crystal Light Company. So many of you know that we love the Festool 400 grit sandpaper. And problem is, it's hard to get during this time of COVID, shipping issues, things like that. It's, you know, the sale that we just recently had, we ran out, just couldn't get it before the sale, and we've not been able to get any until Friday, which was just a half order. So we're running into a lot of problems getting in the lead time on it's just horrendous. So over the past couple of months, we've been working with a manufacturer of sandpapers and have come up with a very similar product. I love the sponge foam. It makes it easy to control, to hold on to, and gives you a little bit of cushion between your pressure applicator, whether it's your fingers. I personally like to use our two-sided sanding sponge on the back of it, grip it, and that gives you a nice flat surface area to work with. But we're going to start carrying this product. Hopefully next week it'll be listed at the store and be going out in all of our kits. We've tested it extensively. Holds up just as good or even better in most situations than the Festool. So don't be alarmed if your second order of sandpaper looks different than your first order. We did stick with the 400 grit. It may feel like it's a little less rough, less grit than the Festool, but it's the exact same grit, and you'll get the exact same results with it. So with that, I want to talk about level sanding. Many of you guys have heard me mention in the group and at the Crystal Light Company to level sand. A lot of folks believe that a level sand is just you're just going across it like this. Some situations that may be all you need, but this is Dorinda's cup. Don't you guys tell her. Don't tell her that I snuck in her craft room and stole this cup to sand. But you've seen this cup in a couple of videos Dorinda's done. It's chunky glitter applied with bright tone. I don't think there's anything else. There's no Mod Podge, anything else, and you can just see it's fabulous. Nice and shiny. It looks like maybe 8 coats, 9 maybe. Could be wrong about that. But the reason that I say that is as you look down the tumbler and the shop lights are reflecting on it, you can still see some of the little dimples, some of the little creases in it from the chunky glitter. I'm going to show you how to fix that. Now, with the level sand, I like to try to keep the sandpaper, you know, as in much contact with it as possible. If you're sanding like this or like this, you're getting contact points of your fingers, and that's the only area that you're touching. So a sanding block, we have a friend that uses the large rubber erasers like you used in when you were in elementary school and things. But I just grab our 220 sanding block. It holds on to the sandpaper real easy, and I can get a nice level surface. So when you're level sanding, don't be afraid to get into the cup. Don't be afraid to get into it. So you can see what I'm doing here. The bright tone will powder up very nicely. I'm not applying very much pressure. Just like with bright tone, you have to let your sandpaper do the work. So see that powdering up? That's why I have a mask on right now and why you need a mask also when you're sanding. You don't want to breathe those particles into your lungs. Now, what I've ended up here with is a nice, it's still got a little gloss to it, but all the high spots, if you can see it, all the high spots where I'm just wiping the dust off are dull, nearly a matte finish. You see all those matte places? I know they're kind of hard to see with my camera, but just keep sanding at about 5 or 6 coats. Now, you don't want to get into your glitter and damage your glitter, but just keep sanding until all those shiny spots are dull. You're going to save you a lot of time and a lot of product if you give it a nice, even, level sand like this. Look at all that dust. Now, that's not that much product coming off. It's just that bright tone, when dry, will powder up like that. And that's the way a finish you want a finish to do. You don't want it to clump into your sandpaper. If it's clumping into your sandpaper, the finish isn't dry. You've applied it too thick and not given it enough time to harden up. So when you're sanding with the 400 grit, if you're not seeing that powder like that and that dull finish come up on it, it could use a little more, still a little bumpy in there. So I'll give it a little more, but that feels much better. Not as near as many dimples and dents and dings in it from the chunky glitter. Oops, sorry, hit the camera. So keep in mind, a quick, 2 minutes there sanding, I could spend 4 or 5 minutes giving that a nice level sand. It's no art to it. It's just covering the entire surface evenly. Light pressure. Let your tools do your work for you. Wouldn't you instead of using a turner, you have to set and turn it like this? No, you've got tools. Use them. Use your turners. You let your sandpaper and your turners and your bright tone do the work for you. Now, we're getting down there now. Yeah, that feels much better, much smoother, much nicer. And there's no big gouges or chunks because I applied light pressure with the right grit sandpaper to a hardened, it's hardened up, finish. Simple and basic. So if anybody has any questions about our new sandpaper, sanding methods or the ways to sand, what it should do when you sand, what it should feel like, what product you're using, and anything else about our products here at the Crystallac Company, just drop a note in the comments. Please like and subscribe, as always. And we're here for you. So if you have any questions, contact us here at the Crystallac Company. You can contact me directly, david@thecrystallaccompany.com, or call our office, 423-727-6425. So hope you guys are having a great weekend. Everybody's healthy and safe. Thanks a lot. Talk to you soon. Bye.